Now, of course, if you're going bass fishing with live shrimp, first thing you need to do is catch yourself some live shrimp. And the easiest way I find to catch them is with one of these push nets, a good quality push net, which you usually use on sandy beaches, and just push the bar there. It's a T-bar on the end of a large net on the end of a pole with another bar at the end there to help you push it through the sand. And the idea is that the bar disturbs the sand, and then the water pressure pushes the shrimps back into the net, and it's a deep net, and then they're trapped in there. Well, where I'm gathering them today, it's not a beach, it's not a sandy beach. As you can see, it's weed. So what I have to do is almost scoop the net through the weed to support it, rather than have it flush as if on the sand, as if you were doing it on the sand, to support it, and then just scoop it, push it through the weed, just sort of shaking it and disturbing the weed as you go, and collect them that way. And then, of course, when I've got enough for the session, off and go and do the fishing. I've got a bucket with me, a live bait bucket, which we'll have a look at in a moment. But you don't necessarily need a live bait bucket. If you pop them in an ordinary bucket with some salt water, obviously salt water and some bit of weed, and if you can change the water now and again, they'll stay alive for quite a while. And of course, and then you get the bycatch there. Looks like we've got a little, yeah, looks like a lovely little, looks to me like a ballonrasse there. And you often get that, which is always quite interesting actually, when you catch the little fish as well. And obviously we're going to pop that back. So yeah, just keep doing that, just pushing it through the weed, just basically disturbing the weed to get the shrimp. It's a little bit harder doing it this way than doing it on a sandy beach because of the resistance of the weed, but you can do it. And it's I only usually spend half an hour, maybe an hour at the most. And usually in that time, I've got enough for my fishing session. Yeah, and we got a few flapping away there. Obviously some will be bigger than others. I don't take the little tiny ones, but as long as they're a reasonable size and big enough for bait, you can always put on, instead of putting one on, you can always put two or three on at the same time. I spent about half an hour shrimping with the push net, and I've got a decent amount of shrimps in there, so should last me a good few hours fishing. And the great thing about this bucket is when I want to take out a shrimp out to bait up, it's got this separate compartment, and I can just lift it up like that and the water will drain. And rather than sort of scooping around in the water trying to grab hold of a shrimp, it drains enough to take one or two out, bait up, and then put the rest back in the water. So all we need to do now is get down to the mark and do some fishing, and hopefully one of these will catch a reasonable bass. Before I start the fishing, we'll have a quick look at the tackle and the rig that I'm going to be using. I've got a 4000 size reel there, and that's loaded with 15 pound braid. And then joined to the end of the braid, I've got a 15 pound fluorocarbon leader, which is twice the length of the rod. But the rod itself is just a 10 foot estuary type rod, and it's capable of casting about 2 to 3 ounces, but light enough for me to hold for a good few hours session. But the important bit down the end, the rig, I've got a bobble float there, and that's just pegged in place. It doesn't move, but it is adjustable. With a little bit of force, I can slide it up or slide it down to alter the length of the line to the hook. And I've got it filled with a bit of water, and that I find is quite important when you're using a bobble float, because the bubble floats are very light, but the water adds a bit of weight. And when you are using live shrimp, when you're casting, you don't want to be putting too much force into the cast, otherwise the hooks can just pull out of the shrimp, which is a bit frustrating. But with a bit of water adding weight, you can just do a gentle cast and cover the distance that you need without putting too much force into the cast. So the fluorocarbon runs down to a hook, and I've got an Aberdeen hook here, fine wire Aberdeen, but it's a short shank Aberdeen, and it's thin enough that when I hook the shrimp, it doesn't destroy the shrimp, but it's very, very strong and capable of dealing with a good sized bass. Now, a little tip I can give you here, you don't have to do this, but I find it quite useful, and that is, I've got a little bit of split shot there, about a foot, maybe a foot and a half away from the hook, just to keep those shrimps down. And I find that quite useful when there's a bit of a chop, bit of a swell, and the drift is quite fast, just to keep, although I'm not fishing deep, I'm fishing in shallow water today, and the length of the trace will range from about 3 foot down to about 6 foot, no deeper than that. So I'm fishing shallow water, but this I find helps, keeps those shrimps down. The baiting up of these shrimp is pretty straightforward. On the back there, they've got segments, and those segments are clearly defined by a line. And what I like to do is, coming up from the underneath, is pop the hook through the centre at around about the second segment. Now, you can put, if the shrimp is a decent size, you can put just one on, but if they're on the small size, then you can put two or three or even four on at a time. Right, I'm ready to start the fishing. And as you can see here, I'm just fishing into a bit of a breeze. It's about low water now, tide will start turning soon. Got it baited up, got a couple of shrimp on to start with. And here I've got a little bit of depth here, so I'm fishing probably about four and a half feet. And that's what I mean. I did a very, very gentle lob there, and because I've got a bit of weight in that bubble float, it was very, very easy to get out a reasonable distance in this gentle breeze. Just to try and show you the take you normally get when you're fishing live shrimp with a bubble float. You got your float floating on the surface there, and what usually happens, the bass will come in and they'll hit these shrimps quite hard. They absolutely love them, and they normally go in quite hard. So what I found is, your first indication is you get a little thump like that where the bass has hit the shrimp, and then it'll either, if you're fishing in very shallow water, the float will either run along the surface like that, or the bass will, you get the bump and the bass will just take it down, just like it would do a conventional pencil float. And even a tiny little bass, a little school bass, has no problem pulling these floats down. And then all you need to do, what I found is, because they take them quite vigorously, they're usually hooked, and all you need to do is just take hold of the rod and take up the tension, and normally the fish is on. Sometimes there's quite an advantage I've found to fishing bait for bass, particularly the live shrimp, as opposed to fishing lures. Now, at this mark I'm fishing, we get a a lot of problems with this stuff. This is called spaghetti weed. But there's also beds of seagrass. Now, even if you're fishing, trying to lure fish, and you're fishing weedless lures, these great clumps of this sitting on the surface, particularly for the first few hours of the flooding tide around the low water period, is a real pain, and it's very, very difficult. But when you're fishing the bubble float with the shrimp, you can actually fish very, very close to these beds and all just let the float drift into it. And then of course your shrimp will be down and in amongst all this weed, and the fish will of course will often come into these beds of seagrass and spaghetti weed rising up from the bottom looking for a meal. So I find it a great alternative to lure fishing when you've got a fish close to very, very weedy areas, or even in weedy areas. Well, only a tiny bass there, but never mind. At least it's a bass, and it didn't take long to catch one, but we obviously need something bigger than that. Well, I can't tell you, emphasize enough, what a fantastic way to fish for bass that this is, fishing with the live shrimp. And I would go as far as to say that it's probably more chance of catching one even than lure fishing. Well, again, it's not a big bass, but it's a reasonable one. It's much bigger than the one before. Well, it's under the size limit. It measures 40 centimeters, so it's going to go back, but never mind, they're getting bigger. And away she goes. Well, the tide forced me off the other mark, so I had to move, but unfortunately the sea has really picked up now, and the breeze has picked up, but it's getting really choppy, and it's brought in just a load of loose weed, and as you can see, it's making it impossible for me to fish. Just getting caught on the line all the time, and I can't get a clean drift. So unfortunately it looks like I'm gonna have to call it a day early. Well, unfortunately, I did have to pack up early. The loose weed was causing too much of a problem, kept getting caught on the line, and it was just too difficult to fish. But I did come back with some excess bait, some lovely shrimp, which of course I'm going to enjoy later. But although on this occasion I didn't get a bass that was big enough for the dinner table, what I'm going to do, I'm going to go back again and using exactly the same methods, see if I can catch a bass that's a little bit bigger. Right, well, I'm back out again to give it another try. And it's just coming up to low water now. I'm gonna fish the first 2 or 3 hours of the flooding tide and see how we do today. Bit bright today, but never mind, the conditions are, and I've got a take. No, yep, I've got a take. And we're in. But only a small one again, I'm afraid. Well, that's encouraging. I then moved to the spot I had fished the day before. And confidence in the method told me that if I persisted and worked my way through the small bass, a bigger bass would eventually come my way. I've got the better bass, and this one is definitely a better one. Fantastic take, it just banged the bobbin in, that was straight down. In fact, it took it so much that it took up all the slack line, and then it was just a straight bang on the rod tip. Unfortunately, I've got a load of weed to try and get this through. Well, I hope this shows you that this method definitely works. Obviously, the bass have got to be... Oh, Christ. The bass have got to be here, of course, to catch them, but it works. And it's a fantastic way of fishing for them. A very relaxing way to target bass. Come on. I've got a load of weed. Oh God, he's only lip hooked. A load of weed around it. Well, there it is, lovely bass, and this one measures just under 50 centimeters. So although I had to be patient and catch a lot of small bass before this one came along, although catching any bass is a pleasure, fantastic that this one came along, and I'm absolutely thrilled. And it just goes to show that this method really does work. They love those live shrimp. Now, of course, we got these new rules that have come out now, where we were only allowed to take one bass per rod per day. So that's my bass, and it's going to be an absolute treat for the dinner table. Well, that's it. I've come to the end of my session. And for those of you that have never tried bubble float fishing for bass with live shrimp before, give it a go. It's a great alternative to maybe just lure fishing for them all the time, or bait fishing on the bottom. The hardest bit, of course, is getting your bait, your live shrimp. But it's also a very relaxing way of targeting bass. Just watching that bubble float just drift along the surface, and then the fantastic excitement when you see it bump and then maybe skip sideways or just pull straight up under is a real thrill. And it can be highly productive. And although most of the bass I caught in the couple of sessions were small, eventually I got the one I was after, and which is an absolute thrill. So I've got a bit of excess bait left over to take home and cook, and then of course our lovely bass, and both are going to be an absolute treat. So once again, I hope you found that useful, and many thanks for watching.